Hey, what's going on? Welcome to week 4 of Fantasy Couch. I'm Hussein the Brain. This is Fantasy Guru Mike Mattar.
What's up, everybody?
Mike, been really, really juiced about week 3 that just happened. I mean, we were spot on with Sid Says. All his predictions were pretty much dead on.
Pretty accurate, yeah. I'm surprised. I mean, Sid called out a lot of good picks. He called out AP not doing so hot against the Niners.
And he didn't.
Yeah, he didn't. He was under 100 yards, no touchdowns, so you could say that the Niners did their job on him.
And Joe Flacco was going to be hot.
Wow, yeah, Joe Flacco. I mean, we knew this kid was good, but we didn't know that he was this good. Like 300 yards, you know, a touchdown. That's a lot of good production out of a fantasy quarterback.
Well, I thought he was going to be good. And his second year, he's going to do better than his first. Let's talk about something that I think is really important is handcuffing. Some people like to handcuff players. Some people don't, but some people don't even know what handcuffing is. So.
Well, basically, okay, handcuffing is like when you have a star running back. Let's say you drafted LT in the first round, or you drafted Matt Forte or Maurice Jones-Drew. What you want to do is you want to get value for those players by taking their backup, you know, drafting him or finding him in later rounds or on the waiver wire. Once you get that player and you can back up your star player, I mean, you're going to get value from either way.
And a good handcuff means that you got to get a secondary back that's good. We got to see that he's explosive. You know, right. He can make it happen. And I want to see that he's been making it happen, at least has good potential while the
experience in the past while the starter was out.
Experience in the past and while the number one running back is still playing. I want to see that he has some kind of spark. Like Chester Taylor, he's shown something in the past, but do you think that's a good handcuff for AP?
I think it's a great – if you have the number one pick, I mean, many people, we all pick AP number one. So if you're going to put that much of a star investment in your player, you got to get his backup. And Chester Taylor, I mean, he's shown that he can do it all. Like he's not a starting caliber running back, but when he's in the lineup, he's going to produce.
I say play it safe, handcuff the first pick of the draft.
You have to. I mean, it only makes sense. Like AP is an investment. You got to look at it that way. You got to protect your investments.
What about this Marion Barber, Felix Jones, Tashard Choice jumbo going on? Would you pick up?
I would pick up. I mean, the smart choice to me is Tashard Choice. Yeah. I mean, Felix Jones, he's great. He's got a lot of explosive ability, but he's very injury prone. And Marion Barber, he's a big bruising running back, but guess what? He's injury prone. So Tashard Choice right now, I think he's your best bet to handcuff.
Yeah, you can get Tashard Choice right now for week 4, but I wouldn't say looking at him past that much, you know, unless Marion Barber and Felix Jones get hurt or you're in a really deep league. And what about Brian Westbrook, handcuff, get LeSean McCoy? What do you think about
him? Oh, yeah, I think you definitely got to get LeSean McCoy. I mean, he's shown a lot of talent out of Pittsburgh. He's a rookie running back. Last game, 20 carries for 84 yards and a touchdown. Like, that's what you want from a starting running back on your fantasy team. And let's face it, Brian Westbrook, he's not getting any younger. He's only starting to decline. He's injury prone as well. So you got to get McCoy in your lineup if you own Brant Westbrook.
You got to handcuff somebody as injury prone as Westbrook. What about Joseph Addai and the Colts? Should you handcuff him? What do you think?
Oh, definitely, yeah. Joseph Addai, I mean, he's shown that he really hasn't done anything in the last two seasons. And they don't show much trust in your star running back when you draft Donald Brown in the first round for the Indianapolis Colts. So I think that definitely if anything happens to Addai or he doesn't play as good as advertised, they're going to put Brown in there.
No, I think Brown's a good pickup. I don't think he has a good handcuff because I don't think Addai just has the value, enough value for a player to handcuff. And Donald Brown's good as a dynasty pick, and I put him on the bench, but I don't say that's the ideal handcuff. Now, what about Ronnie Brown on the Dolphins?
Well, to me, I think that Ricky Williams really like that's a stretch for a handcuff pick. Because Ronnie Brown, he's a very durable back. He gets a lot of touches in the Wildcat formation, and usually he doesn't hand the ball off to Ricky Williams. He usually keeps it and runs for himself. So if you're playing, if you're trying to have both those players on your team, I don't know. I think you could do a lot better than Ricky Williams.
I think Ricky Williams is a good pickup. He had a receiving touchdown and a rushing touchdown already in the season. And with Pennington hurt, I mean, they're going to be running it. So I'd say you can start both of them in some weeks depending on the matchup. So I think they're both good. They both put up stats this year. Now, what do you think about Frank Gore?
Well, now that we know that he's injured, Glenn Coffey is really someone that you should look out for. I mean, he's a rookie running back who's shown a lot of poise in the preseason. He's shown he could produce. Like, this kid's got star potential written all over him. And with Frank Gore out, I think you should definitely grab Coffey while you can.
Week 4, the Niners play the Rams. What's going to happen?
Terrible run defense. These guys are going to get run on all game
long. It's not looking good for the Niners. So week 4, I say Glenn Coffey's a great pickup. Past that, I don't know. I'm going to have to watch him for at least 2 weeks, see what he can do.
We'll have to wait and see.
But he does have potential. I give him that. Let's see if he has fantasy value. Now, what about players that haven't been doing good the first 3 weeks, as in the buy low options? Who can you get right now?
Well, you can get Clint Portis, and he's shown that he's amassed 177 yards rushing, zero TDs, but he's been a disappointment so far. Like, I drafted Matt Forte in the first round, and I'm looking to either sell him right away or try to ride it out for the rest of the season.
Forte is more of a first-round pick. Portis is more like a second-round pick.
Right.
But I like Portis. He had zero touchdowns, as you said, this year. But I think he's going to get more. The Redskins have been embarrassed, and they're going to turn things around. They got to be angry. They got to do something out there in Washington. And what about Roddy White, wide receiver for the Falcons?
I think he's still got a lot of potential to do well this season. I owned Roddy White last year, and I know he can be up and down, but he can also produce. With Matt Ryan as his quarterback, the aerial game is definitely going to be there. I mean, he only has one TD so far in the season, but, I mean, buy low if you can still get this guy, because he is definitely going to have games where he breaks out for two or more touchdowns.
This guy was good last season, so I don't know. I don't really like him. He usually gets picked up in third round, maybe fourth round in drafts, so I don't think you're going to be able to trade anyone sucky enough to get him. I don't think anyone's going to bite. They're going to probably hold on to him, and I just stay away from Roddy White on my roster. What about Greg Olsen?
Well, Greg Olsen is a guy that I had early in the season, but I gave up on him after two subpar games. But now that Jay Cutler's coming back to form, he has two TDs in the last game. I'm kind of regretting dropping him. I mean, someone probably picked him up on the waivers already, so I'm kind of too late. So I got to roll with what I have right now.
Y'all say this guy's a great buy low. Him and Cutler's going to have better chemistry throughout the year. That's how I see it happening. It was just a bad week one for the Bears offense in general.
Yeah, shouldn't have gave up too early. That's the lesson.
Now, speaking of tight ends, though, there's some sleeper tight ends out there. And a tight end I think is better than Greg Olsen, a lot of people we haven't heard of, is Brent Suh. Do you like this guy?
Oh, yeah. This kid's been really phenomenal lately. He had 22 catches for 245 yards, two TDs on the season. Like, this guy pretty much came out of nowhere. And to have this type of season this early in the season, I think that bodes well for his future.
Yeah, I'm a big Brent Suh fan. I don't know why you guys haven't heard of him or picked him up, but pick him up right now. He's good. He's a top five tight end.
Great player.
Do you like Vernon Davis?
Wow, that's a tough question. I mean, as a Niner fan.
As a fan, what about fantasy value, though?
Fantasy points. He has to break out. If this is not his year to be a fantasy like producer, then I would never draft him or stay away from him as long as you can. Because if Vernon Davis can't show that he's got what it takes this year, I think that you should just give up. But he's had two TDs in his last game, so you know that he could score. This might be the year that Brendan Davis breaks out.
So are you saying he's inconsistent? Are you saying
he's very inconsistent.
You're saying he's worth putting on your bench or maybe starting or what?
Definitely. That would be the best case scenario. I mean, against good matchups, against the Rams this week, I think that would be a good time to employ him if you have him on your roster as a backup tight end. Put him in the lineup, see what he can do, you know.
Good game to test him.
Yeah, great. If he doesn't have any touchdowns this week, then just put him back. It's easy as that.
I like Vernon Davis. I think he's gonna get better. I mean, he's worth looking in deeper leagues and start him week four, see what happens.
What about running backs?
Running backs right now, I think there's a guy who's getting a lot of touchdowns. His name is McGahee. What do you think about him?
Oh yeah, I definitely love his game. I have McGahee on my roster right now. And early on the season, though, it was tough because I didn't know who would get the carries. It would be Ray Rice, him. But, I mean, we know that who the red zone back is this year, and that's definitely Willis McGahee. He's got multiple touchdown games every week, so he's doing pretty good.
Yeah, he might not be doing as good as his first few weeks, but I think he's going to get better, maybe. Maybe not put up as many touchdowns, but we'll see. What about the Marshawn Lynch situation and the Bills situation, and what do you do with him? Do you stick him in? Do you try him?
I think you just got to see how he plays this week. If he shows that he's still got what it takes, I mean, I heard that he's been keeping in shape over the suspension, so he's definitely, he's definitely able to produce and put in numbers when he's in the lineup. I mean, Fred Jackson's shown that he is a legitimate fantasy starter, but Marshawn Lynch, I mean, he's been basically the Bills' whole offense the past two, three seasons, so you can't ever count out a back with his talent.
I think he's going to be the missing key to the Bills. I think he's a great back. He's going to come fresh because he hasn't played the first three games, got banged up the first three games. And I think he's going to get you a few TDs. It's probably worth starting him, I'd say.
He can catch, too. Don't forget that. So he's got a lot of, in PPR, points per reception leagues, adds value.
Exactly. Well, I'm Hussein the Brain signing off.
Mike Mittal.
Hit us up on Twitter. Ask us any questions via email.
Fantasy Couch. We'll answer it
next show, fantasycouch.com.
Peace.
Peace.